Good morning, friends. In the last lectures, we studied, we started the chain drive and we discussed what are the advantages of the chain drives over the belt drives or gear drives, and what are the disadvantages of the chain drives over generally over the gear drive and belt drive. And we discussed two types of the chain. Actually three types of the chain. So one is the link type of the chain for lifting up of the load and for lowering up of the load. Second type of the chain is the power transmissions, that is the means for power transmissions. Two three types. One is the because of the due to rolling frictions and transmissions above the power, and because of the sliding frictions also transmissions above the power, means that is the C type of the chain, but that is C type of the or D type of the chain. So this is not in as or in syllabus. But second type of the chain is the silent chain, which is used for high speeds, and that is as per our Dr. Batu University syllabus, Miss Ambedkar University, Miss as per Batu University syllabus. So that's why today we'll see. We already studied link chain for lifting up of the load and for the lowering up of the load. Now, today we'll discuss roller chain. So, in roller chain parts or component of roller chain, that is pins, bush, inner plate, link, outer plate, link. This is bush and you can say this is roller. These are the five parts. Suppose this is construction, this is upper part, now this is so here's inner part. Here also and this is bushing and this is a roller. this is outer plate link which is to be joined. This is inner plate link, and here this is pin. Pin. This is bush, and this is roller. These are the five components of the chain, and this distance, this is called pitch. This is equal to pitch, P. So the size above the chain or dimensions above the chain, dimension of chain, maybe this is simplex or duplex, and simplex size 516, 38, half inch, 58 inch, after that 3/4 inch, 1 inch, 1.5 inch, 1 1/4, 1.5 inch likewise. So this 516 means near about 8 mm, 38 means and near about 9 point something mm, this is 12.5 mm approximately. So this is approximately because I am not remembering, and this is 15 point something, this is 3/4 means 19 point something, 1 inch means 25.4, this is around 32 mm, and this is around 40 mm. So these are the size above the chain. So this may be a diamond type or chain type. This is not diamond, Renault or Morse chain, and make. So popular chain manufacturer is in India diamond. So this is more popular, diamond make chain is more popular as compared to other types, and this types of the chain is the Renault type, and I guess I think Morse type of the chain. So this is construction of the roller chain now, and generally number of links is generally even. So number of the links generally evens for the roller chain. And here one link which is required, that link is one link required to join two ends of chain, that is called lock, or and this is full link lock or half link. So half link, full link means here two rollers, and half link means only one rollers, and by using lock. So these are the some of the, so this may be, you may be know, so this full link because if you are using bicycle, so here's full means full link lock and half link lock. This is, you may be familiar with the because these two types we can use for the joining up of the two ends above the chain. So next article about the chain drive is geometrical construction of chain drive. Geometric relationship. So in chain drives, the number of the teeth above the sprocket, so that may be 11, 17 or 24. So generally number of the teeth, a minimum number of the teeth for the chain sprocket, that is 21 or 23. For understanding my messages, suppose this is a chain drive and this is sprocket here. And in the belt drives, pulleys, two pulleys, one is the drive pulley and another is the driven pulley. Here, sprocket, one is the drive sprocket and another is the driven sprocket. Suppose this is a sprocket. Having teeth. So likewise. Suppose likewise of the sprocket. So this angle is the alpha and chain. So these are the roller. So this is alpha and this is P is the pitch and this is, or you can say this is capital D is the pitch circle diameter of sprocket. This is capital D, P is pitch of teeth. So this is teeth, pitch means above the two teeth, and alpha is profile angle. Or pitch angle. So this is not profile angle, this is pitch angle. So that's why here alpha equal to 360 divided by this is z is number of teeth on sprocket. Alpha equal to 360 divided by z, or sine alpha equal to 2 equal to p by 2 divided by capital D by 2, or D equal to capital P by 2 into sine. So this 2 will get cancelled, sine alpha divided by 2, or since D equal to P divided by sine 180 divided by this is z, because alpha equal to 360 divided by z, so that's why here we can write 180 divided by z. The velocity ratio of the chain drive, the velocity ratio of chain drive that can be calculated by using I equal to Z2 divided by Z1, or N1 divided by N2. So Z1, Z2, number of teeth on sprocket, and N1, N2, RPM of sprockets. So you understand this Z2 means this is the D1 sprocket, number of teeth above the D1 sprocket, and this Z1 is the drive sprocket. This is the RPM of the drive sprocket, and this is the RPM of the D1 sprocket. So the average velocity, of chain is given by V equal to pi dN divided by 60 into 1000. So this is you will get in terms of meter per second. So this D, if you are taking, and this is D1 and this is N1, and if you are taking this is D2 and this is N2. So what it may be? That take same. So yes, pi d equal to Zp, because pi d equal to Zp into n this is number of teeth above the sprocket, and p is the pitch. The length above the chain drive that can be calculated length up of the chain equal to ln into p. This right? Right. So ln is number of links in the chain. So ln is, so by using this you can calculate the length of the chain. Now how we can calculate the total length of the chain? Or the number of links ln is determined by using relation ln equal to 2 divided by a divided by p plus Z1 plus Z2 divided by 2 plus Z1 minus Z2 or Z2 minus Z1, because this is more, divided by 2 pi. This is 2 pi plus or multiplied by p by a. So where a is approximately center distance between two sprocket and Z1, number of teeth of, and this is drive sprocket and this is Z2 is number of teeth of D1 sprocket, and A is the center distance, P is the pitch of the teeth of link, chain link. This is called chain link. So by using this formula you can calculate the total number of the links that is can be determined. So by using this relation, so next article. Now so in the sum of the books this is given, chain drive is the positive drive, but actually chain drive is not a positive drive. So you can say this is positive drive if you compare with the belt drives. So why this is happen, so that we will study. Suppose yeah, 4 number of teeth. So this angle equal to this is alpha. Now here's
So this is supports D by 2. This is A, B, C, D, and E. This is rotating likewise. So that's why this is tight side and this is loose side. Both are in tension. A, B, C, D, E. Now this is V is the maximum velocity. If this is the case, maximum velocity, and if suppose in this case now this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, and this is E. This is E. Now, this angle is alpha by 2, and the speed this is the V minimum. So this is maximum and this is minimum. So this is why this is happen, because if this is at this position, so this angle is the alpha and this angle is the alpha by 2. So this is the advanced. So because of that slightly variations in the chain in the velocity. So this in this case you will get maximum velocity, and in this case you will get minimum velocity. But this is the difference in the velocity, this maximum velocity and minimum velocity. So that formula given. So this is D by 2. And in this case, this is D by 2 into cos alpha by 2. So because of these relations, you will get this is maximum speed and this minimum speed. So this difference, so because of the, this is polygonal effect. Because of maximum speed and minimum speed means speed variations in chain drive. So this is happen due to polygonal effect. So this is happen due to polygonal effect. This effect are called as polygonal effect. So that's why you will not get the exact velocity ratio. So if number of teeth Z1 equal to E11, so the efficiency So this is, so if number of teeth on sprocket increased, you will get exact velocity ratio, exact velocity ratio. So that's why for Z equal to L1 number of teeth observed speed variation of 4%. So 4% above the speed variations if Z equal to number of L1 number of teeth, and if Z equal to 17, speed variation of 1.6%, and when if Z is 24 or more than 24, so the speed variation, so you may be confused, what is mean about the speed variation? So this speed variation is nothing but this is V max minus V minimum is below 1%, is below 1%. So that's why minimum number of teeth for sprocket is 21 or 23. So this is the minimum number of the teeth on the sprocket, and generally number of teeth on sprocket should be odd, because both are odd, and the number of the links, that is generally even. So this number of the teeth on the sprocket should be odd, likewise 21, 23, 17, etc. So this is a polygonal effect. So as per the considerations of the polygonal effect, we have to use minimum number of the teeth on the sprocket, that is 21 or 23 teeth. This is given in the various book. So actually, if the number of the teeth, this is near about 24, so this is analogy. So by using experimental data, if the number of the teeth on the sprocket 24, the speed variations means maximum speeds and minus minimum speeds, and that is less than 1%. Otherwise, if the number of the teeth on the sprockets are minimum, so that will affect the speed variations, means you will not get the exact velocity ratio, because in the some of the cases you request exact velocity ratio. So exact velocity ratio, actually that is also not getting, means up to that much, because in the gear drive. So because in the gear drive, some of the, because of the backlash or because of the play in the teeth up of the, and that is for engaging, and during the disengaging of the teeth up of the gears, so some of the play may be occurs. So because of that, but that is negligible. So in this case, sprocket, this speed variation slightly greater than the gear drive. So gear drive's variation, speed variations is very less as compared to the chain drives.
and speed variations is more in the belt drives. So that's why belt drive is not called as a positive drive, that is negative drive. And in the chain drives, so here's in the gear drives, the power is transmitted from one shaft to the another shaft because of the sliding frictions. And here's the friction is, that is to be considered, this is the rolling frictions in the chain drives. So try to understand. So in chain drive, so these small questions may be asked during the examination. So chain drive, what I said, rolling frictions is occur and in gear drives sliding friction occur. So another one important points as compared to belt drives in the chain drives. So in the belt drives, so as per the considerations above, the arc of contact on this lower side is the this is loose side and this is tight side in belt drive. But in chain drive, this is opposite case, because being as a mechanical engineer, you should know. So this is sprocket. So this should be, and this is loose side. So this is rotating likewise, clockwise. This is tight side. And this is loose side. So this is because in this case, in the chain drive, this chain is to be released, and here's because of the to increase arc of contact. This is for increase arc of contact for to improve efficiency. So in this case, releasing up of the chain, releasing of chain is important as compared to, because this is tight side and this is the releasing. So because here no necessary above the arc of contact because of the friction, because of the here, so engaging up of the chain, transmissions above the power. So that's why this is not the case. So and chain drives, used generally only in horizontally. So belt drives generally more popular is the horizontal, but in some of the cases vertical also you can use by providing crowning on the pulleys. And V belt drives you can use horizontal drives or vertical drives. But chain drives, this is, so generally such type of the shaft should be, this is horizontal position. So the shaft is not vertically. So this is the case, otherwise means a chain may be come out. So this is the case, only horizontally we can use chain drives, and belt drives we can use popularly horizontally, and vertically also use. In this case also you use vertically, but you will face more problem of the chain come out from the sprockets. So that's why for avoid that, chain drive generally used horizontally. So this is the case, this is more important if you compare chain drives and belt drives. So next articles, power rating. Chain drive. So power rating of the chain drive kilowatt, that can be calculated by using P1 into V divided by 1000. V is the velocity of chain and P1 is the allowable tension in chain drive. So this is important. P1 is the, so this allowable tensions in the chain drive is very less as compared to the tensions in the belt drives, because in the belt drives that power is to be transmitted, that depends on the how much is the tension. So because of the tension applied, so that imposed heavy load on the shaft and bearing. So that's why failure of the belt may be happens. So here in this case, so this tension, medium tension is to be applied. So if tension is more wear rate is more, and if tension is low, so chain may be broken. Wear rate is more, so this is not given in the book. So next is the article, sprocket wheels. So sprocket wheels, that can be manufactured by using disc or by welded or by jointing sprocket.
whose pocket may be and this is disc type of this pocket. Disc type and diameter is 100 mm and if this is more than 100 mm, so here's in this case this may be this may be welded. So actually this is not the this distance is small. So this is welded. Welded and this is jointed type. This may be jointed, I think, from both sides. So this is jointed type sprocket wheel. So these are the three types of the. So if the diameter is more and more power is to be transmitted, so generally this is preferred. Otherwise this is for small power transmission and this is for medium and this is for large power transmission and if the velocity ratio is more. So these are the three types of the sprocket wheels. So next is the silent chain. So when high speed is required, when high speed of chain drive is required, we can use silent chain. So the shape of the teeth, this is the trapezoidal type of the teeth and this is noiseless. It is noiseless and some of the another advantage of the chain drives. More heavier, so manufacturing of chain is more complicated, but some of the this is noiseless and
we can use for high speeds. Complicated and expensive as compared to chain drives. So chain drives means this is expected type of the roller chain. So these are the advantage means silent chain. In the silent chain, this is a trapezoidal teeth of the this is trapezoidal type. So likewise trapezoidal teeth, so this is link, so here's on the link, one link, here teeth, trapezoidal type of the teeth, likewise, so this is the shape of the silent chain. So instead of the roller or bush, and so this is the such type of the trapezoidal tip means plate, and this is the plate used for, and this is the having very hard materials or having more hardness above the plate that is required for the silent chain. So this is the plate used, and in the roller chain that is roll used. So this is a silent type of the chain. So that's why today I stop here, and in the next class we'll start. Next is the fifth unit, that is the design above the belt drives or design above the clutch drives. So that's why in the next class we'll start design above the clutch. So in the clutch, three types of the clutch. One is the single plate clutch, another is the multi plate clutch, and third type of the clutch is the centrifugal clutch. So in the next class we'll see clutch drives. So because clutch is required for engagement of the drives and disengagement of the drives according to the requirements. So that's why in the next class we can start the next chapter is the chain drives. Thank you.